All right, here we have the ant plant. There are lots of different kinds of ant plants. They're native to Southeast Asia. But all of them share, all the different varieties of these share something in common, and that is that they are, they have a symbiotic relationship with ants. Okay, so down here in this little bulb, it's called a codex. It's a series of, it's full of like little mazes, kind of like what you would see like an ant make underground, but it's naturally inside of these bulbs, these little codex. And in nature, the ants have their little homes in there. It's not invasive or parasitic in any way. Basically what happens is the plant, or the ants get nutrients from the plants, and the plant gets nutrients from the ants' excrement, right? So it's sort of a symbiotic relationship, a really cool thing, and a fun little fact for the ant plants. But let's get into the care instructions for these guys. First of all, taking in mind that in nature, like I said, they grow, they're epiphytes, right? So they grow on the sides of trees. So bringing that indoors, that means we need to give them very bright light. Full shade outdoors is brightest light we can possibly offer indoors, right? So very bright light plant, give it the best light you can give, wide view of the sky. A south window or a west window would work great. East would also work, but north would not be sufficient year round. Next, let's talk about watering. So they want to drain very quickly, like I said, so they grow as epiphytes. They don't grow in the ground, so they're not used to retaining a bunch of moisture. They're used to it raining. It rains a lot in Southeast Asia, very intermittently. You know, it might be nice and sunny for most of the day, and then they have a quick 10-minute shower three times a day, you know, something like that. So they want their roots to stay damp, but they want to drain very quickly. So this is planted primarily in bark, the same sort of bark that an orchid would be planted in. And the care for them is actually very similar to orchids in that way, is that they like to drain very quickly, but they still want to stay fairly damp. Okay, so that's the next thing. After that, let's talk about fertilizing. So you don't need to fertilize these guys at all. They're very slow growers. They're used to taking in nutrients through the air. Okay, so whatever nutrients we have for them in here anyway is perfectly fine. You know, that's in the potting medium already. There's no need to add anything extra. Okay, so fertilizer, no go. It'll be perfectly fine just in the potting medium that it's in. Next, we'll talk about humidity. Oftentimes, these guys get a bad rap for a humidity, but really it's more of a watering problem than it is a humidity problem. Okay, so like I said, they don't want to get super, super dry. If they dry out too much, the leaves will become really, really limp and they'll start to yellow and fall off. So we want to make sure that we're keeping up with that moisture. As long as you are watering properly, humidity is not really a problem, unless, you know, inside your home you have like a dehumidifier nearby or an open flame fire that's sucking out a lot of the humidity and making your home dry. But with typical household humidity, the ant plants will do perfectly fine. But that's going to do it for the care instructions for the ant plant. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment section below, or you can always message me on Tanner the Planner.